It's been nearly a week since President Biden signed an executive order aimed at cracking down on illegal border crossings. We needed this to happen. The move, some say, though, it's been a long time coming. And the executive order embraces stricter policies on asylum seekers when the daily average of illegal crossings exceeds, get this number, 2,500. Southern border averages haven't been lower than that in years. President Biden saying Republicans left him no choice. President Trump, on the other hand, calling it a meaningless PR ploy. So which one is it? News Nation's Tom Dempsey joins us now live. Tom, you've really looked at these numbers. How much of an impact are we seeing so far?
Hey, good morning, Anna. Yeah, this morning, News Nation has obtained new data from the border showing the days before this executive action got put in place and the days after. And to answer your question, the data show that we really haven't seen much of an impact due to this executive order. Let's get right to it. Customs and Border Protection provided these numbers to News Nation, showing over 3,500 encounters along the southern border for the three previous days before the executive order went into effect. But starting on Wednesday last week, with the executive order in full effect, the number of border encounters really saw no significant changes. We saw a bit of a drop on Friday, but then on Saturday, the number of migrants in custody actually shot up. So these types of numbers are going to be very key to watch in the next few days, weeks, and months, because supporters of this plan are going to really want to see some sort of a dent when it comes to encounters. But opponents are going to use numbers like this to show that much, much more needs to be done to address the border crisis. And this plan for President Biden doesn't go far enough, Anna.
Yeah, Jorge Ventura shot some video himself, and it was just people are just crossing the border and from all different countries, too, something we haven't seen as much in the past. What reaction have we been seeing recently to this plan?
Well, the American Civil Liberty Union, for one, Civil Liberties Union, also known as the ACLU, they're going to be key to watch the next few weeks because they're very much against this plan and have already threatened to, bring the challenge to court. We want to show you a statement that was provided from one of the leaders of the ACLU who wrote, quote, "We need solutions to address the challenges at the border, but the administration's planned executive actions will put thousands of lives at risk." But this opposition continues, too. Governor Greg Abbott, a Republican in Texas, also came out in a recent interview saying he believes this executive action will actually attract and incite illegal crossings. Homeland Security Secretary Alejandro Mayorkas, though, recently defended the plan, saying it will change the risk calculus for migrants before they leave their home, and it encourages them to find a lawful pathway to the United States. Mayorkas even went on to say that it's going to take time to see the true impact of this plan, and that kind of is true right now because we really haven't seen much impact, at least in the days after this executive order got put in place, Anna.
Yeah, well, it's going to take some time for word to travel, and hopefully they hear that things are changing in America. Hopefully they'll change even more. Tom Dempsey, thanks so much for that.
Thanks for watching, everybody. Go to joinnn.com to find News Nation on your television provider. Also, don't forget to click that red subscribe button below to get more of News Nation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.